Everyone knows that steel reinforcement bars have rips on their surface, which are more commonly known as deformations. But this was not always the case. Up until the 1950s, the designs varied between plain and deformed bars. It was later found that plain bars do not perform well. They are especially poor in earthquakes, so many old bridges and buildings had to be retrofitted. But how much of a difference do these tiny bumps on the surface of the bar actually make to the overall capacity of the structure? The purpose of the steel reinforcement is to undertake the tensile loads that the concrete is poor at resisting. In structural engineering, the concrete is assumed to have zero tensile strength, and therefore all of the tension forces are taken by the steel rebar. This is of course not true in reality, but it is a good conservative approximation. Let's have a look at a concrete beam. The bending of the beam causes the bottom side to crack and separate. If the rebar had no bond to the concrete, then the concrete would move independently of the steel and the crack would keep widening and growing. The part of the beam that's cracked is neutralized and cannot carry any load, which means the remaining concrete must pick up the load. This will lead to overloading and eventually crushing of the concrete. When the bond between the steel and the concrete is sufficiently strong, widening of the concrete is prevented by the reinforcement that holds both sides of the crack in place. You can see why ensuring a proper bond is crucial. The bond in the plain bar is purely due to the adhesion, which is fairly weak. The deformed bar grabs on more material with its deformations and essentially must crush the concrete if it was to pull out or slip. Experimental studies in the 1940s set on to quantify just how important these little bumps are. One such study in 1949 tested a number of rebars with different types of deformations. The test consisted of a 4-point bending setup with concrete beams of 20 by 45 centimeters in cross-section. This type of loading is for experimental purposes and it is not very common in actual structures, but nevertheless, it clearly shows the effects of the deformations. First, the base case was tested, which was a plain bar with no deformations. The beam quickly reached a plateau in the loading and kept deflecting until it failed at a total load of 10.8 tons. The rebar of the second beam had deformations, but they were 3.5 centimeters apart, essentially putting it somewhere between a plain and a fully deformed bar. Even these infrequent bumps already had a drastic effect on the load carrying capacity of the beam, reaching a maximum load of 20.7 tons before failure. Lastly, a beam with fully deformed rebar was tested. The rebar of this beam are similar to the rebar commonly used in construction today, with the deformations only 1 centimeter apart. The capacity of this beam almost tripled the beam with plain reinforcement, reaching 34.8 tons before failure. These findings were astonishing. Small little bumps on your reinforcement can more than triple the strength of your concrete beam. Note that these numbers would differ for different loading scenarios, but in general, the deformed rebar blows the plain rebar out of the water in almost all cases. Plain reinforcing is still used in some applications, such as transverse stirrups. Why do you think this is the case? Let me know in the comments, and while you're down there, consider liking and subscribing to the channel. Thanks for watching, see you next time.